Hey guys, welcome back. Now, I guess in the recent years, almost every developer is talking about machine learning, right? So I thought, let us make some interesting video regarding machine learning and PHP, right? Now, if you are a Python developer, you must be using TensorFlow and whatnot, right? Different libraries and packages of Python to implement your machine learning tasks and achieve the results, right? It's the best way, I must say. But if you're a PHP developer and you want to develop machine learning applications, you want to achieve some machine learning tasks using PHP, so can you do that, right? So I was receiving lots of requests regarding PHP and machine learning. So we'll start with the basics of machine learning, what exactly it is, and can you use PHP. In order to use PHP, what exactly you need and how you can achieve that using PHP. So let us start with this machine learning and PHP session, right? So basically, machine learning is a domain of artificial intelligence. If you know about machine learning, then it's a good thing. And if you are a beginner and if you are a newbie or a completely naive user in machine learning, then you must read about machine learning first of all, then watch this video in order to implement things using PHP, okay? Now, machine learning is basically teaching your system or a application in such a way that it will automatically do different things such as classification, finding any label, finding certain outputs by itself. So what we do, we have a data and we call it as a training data, okay? So we give certain data to train our system. So we say, okay, we have this kind of data and we have certain outputs, certain inputs. So you learn these things using this data, and after that you build something called as models. So we have different models, and you can Google it, linear models and geometric models and different models, okay? So you select a model based on what exactly you want to achieve, and after that you feed that model a data called as test data. So you give the model the data that model has never seen, so it's completely new. So you want to check whether that new data is classified or whether it gives perfect results or not for that new data that the machine has not seen until now, right? So this is basically the flow of machine learning tasks and all those things. So there are different things we can do, such as classification or clustering. There are basically two types of learning mechanisms. We call it supervised and unsupervised learning. In supervised learning, we have data as well as the output associated with that data points. Data points is nothing but the instances or the input records, you can say in simple words. And in unsupervised learning, you do not have the labels or output of data that we have given associated with that particular instance. Okay, so these are the two mechanisms. We'll not go in much detail regarding machine learning, its types and all those things. You just Google those things, just read it out, and you'll get an idea about machine learning and its all aspects. Now, the point is that what exactly you want to build with machine learning. So I'll give you a simple example of spam. So everyone uses Gmail, Ymail or Rediff mail or etc. mail services, right? Now you receive different spams. You have won 1 crore rupees from Coca-Cola and etc. So these are basically spams, right? So how Google automatically detects that this email is spam and automatically transfers that email into the spam box. So have you ever thought of this thing? So these things are achieved using the machine learning, and different background things are done. I'm just giving an abstract view of what exactly is done using machine learning. So you basically give the machine previous emails that are already identified as spam. So machine like extracts data from that email, such as you have won and all these keywords, and like the machine learns these are the spam emails, and if in future we get such emails, we'll be classifying those emails into spam box. Okay, so this is basically an application, you can say, of machine learning. Then face detection and different things are there. You can just Google it out and find different examples what exactly you can build with machine learning. Okay, now the interesting part. Now you want to implement all these things and you want to achieve different outcomes of machine learning using PHP. So how can you do that, right? So there is a library called as PHP-ML. It's not an official of PHP, but it is developed and it is under progress. So you can use that to achieve simple tasks such as classification using KNN. If you already have studied about machine learning algorithms, then you must be knowing what is KNN. That is K nearest neighbor. So you can achieve small things using this library. We'll just see an example. I'll be just showing you, just observe this example that I am showing you. We have different data sets and we are using KNN algorithm and we want to classify whether the given data is A or B. So these are labels, you can say A and B. We already have trained the our model and we want to predict the new output that we have given. So we are calling predict method and we are getting a result such as in this example, you can see B is given. I have taken this example from its official website, PHP-ML. It is hosted on GitHub. You can just get that library and use it in your PHP applications. But the drawback is that we cannot say it's a drawback, but a limitation we can say. You need PHP version 7.0 and greater in order to use this library. If you do not have PHP 7.0 and greater than that version, this library won't work. So make sure you have PHP 7.0 updated and all the required things in your system in order to use this library. Okay, so there are a whole lot of things on this PHP-ML docs. You can just read those things. I have given the link in the description. Just go to that link and read about the documentation, how you can use different algorithms, classification, clustering, and all those things. So that's it. I cannot go in much detail. I'm sorry for that. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like and also share with your friends. And if you love my videos, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.